Picking an episode involving Palutena was a lot more tricky considering that in the majority of her appearances, she is the best developed gem out of any of the supporting characters. And every time I watch a character instantly interact with Palutena, she instantly takes the spotlight as the best gem regardless. And let me just say this right now, the reason why I decided to pick this episode, the Kindergarten Kid, than any of the other episodes, is mostly because of how Palutena develops even after she turns into a crystal gem. Granted that Kindergarten Kid is a standard Palutena episode than anything, but the more I look into this episode, the more I realize that Palutena gets extra development when it comes to her on-screen appearances. Compared to Lapis and other characters, it's really an accomplishment when these screenwriters are putting more focus on Palutena, since that she is the best character when it comes to side characters. Granted, I can say all characters, but at the same time, I still prefer other characters than Palutena. Just saying. The plot of this episode is the Crystal Gems are trying to find more corruptive gems that kept wreaking havoc in the Bay of Kindergarten. And for the majority of this episode, Steven and Palutena have to work together to stop or at least capture one of the corrupted gems. Now, with this plot being a lot more simplified for what the characters need to accomplish, it's usually mostly a filler episode of what people make it out to be when it comes to other Steven Universe episodes. And for that, I somewhat agree with most of the criticisms towards the filler episodes, but for me personally, regardless of being mostly a filler episode, other than just the crystal gems trying to capture more corrupted gems, it really made me invested for what Palutena can do considering that she is the shortest and littlest gem in the crystal gems. In previous Palutena episodes, she's having a difficult time gaining adjustment after using her limp enhancers, since those are literally the only equipment that made her taller and much more dangerous. And in all honesty, just by seeing this episode after those episodes, it really feels like they're trying to give Palutena more of a purpose than just completing her character arc. What I mean by that is that her arc is completed in the second season, mainly for her reforming herself as a crystal gem, even though that she never became a crystal gem to begin with during her experiences in outer space. In all honesty, the development that she gets in Season 3 and onward is mostly of how she's accomplishing new things when it comes to her becoming a crystal gem on Earth. Her experiences in Beach City, along with the events happening in this episode, I really feel like they really knew what to do with Palutena a lot more than I give it credit for, especially in filler episodes like these. As for what this plot does involving Steven and Palutena trying to capture the corrupted gem, it's mostly a wild coyote chasing the world one no thing from Newtoons, and even if I did not enjoy Newtoons that much, I still found the wild coyote chasing world one no thing a lot more humorous, even though that it can get a lot more old after a while. But considering that Newtoons do different things and the fact that this is mostly taking inspiration from Newtoons, I really have nothing against this whatsoever. Not only it follows the plot, but it also gives Steven some kind of a purpose. Granted, people can debate that the Steven-only perspective is irritating, but considering that this isn't a Beach City episode or a Connie episode when it comes to her being solo, I really feel like he still does something in order to help out Palutena's solution in this episode. When he threw marshmallows at her, which causes her to rage, it was the same feeling that the corrupted gem is feeling, especially since that corrupted gem was Palutena in the situation before she became a crystal gem by the end of the second season. This proves to me that the Screen Wilds, regardless of their disadvantages, really care about Peridot in any shape or form. Regardless if she got more development than the other characters, that doesn't mean that she gets all the attention. And whenever she gets the chance to shine, she just probably just dominates the episode entirely, not just because of how hilarious she is, but also the fact that she can deliver the best moments, mostly for her contributing something by completely capturing a corrupted gem before it's too late. In all honesty, regardless of what you feel involving the other characters not getting as much attention, I'm pretty sure it wasn't Peridot whatsoever. If she was in every single episode after she became a crystal gem, then maybe I would say that she's overshadowing other gems. Granted, people can say that there are other ways for other characters like Lapis and Bismuth that have different character developments that I'm not aware of, even after reviewing White, So Blue, and Bismuth, but on the other hand, I really feel like, regardless of what trait that they have, they probably just didn't got a lot of recognition compared to Peridot. And it's mostly the fact of how Peridot is portrayed compared to the other characters. Regardless of trauma or being trapped in the bubble for so many centuries regardless, I still feel like the Peridot probably had the best development when it comes to luck. Even though that luck ended up becoming proper development compared to other characters. Besides, I would be lying if I say this is the best Peridot episode compared to her other appearances, which it isn't. In all honesty, this isn't the best Peridot episode compared to other of her appearances, but on the other hand, this episode is still decent. With this being the first episode of the fourth season, I actually can tell that they really knew how to handle Peridot's character a lot more even after the second season. Granted, whenever I get to those types of episodes involving her development, it will probably be an episode where it centers around her trust towards the other characters, but on the other hand, I have to pick the White episode that actually works out when it comes to her arc in the second season. Although that also means that I might skip on her relationship with Lapis. If you really expect me to review Barmaids, let me just say, it's probably the most obvious thing to review to consider on how Lapis is portrayed in that episode due to her trauma. And if I'm ever going to talk about that relationship, it could be on a different episode that can easily work out, depending on how the characters are portrayed, which also includes Peridot. Maybe whenever I get the chance to do a Steven Universe week or marathon to review the majority of its episodes, I might be able to have the chance to clear up everything that I haven't discussed. But at the same time, it will be like Rebirth Bells all over again, where I have to review an episode well you want me to review, but at the same time, it's difficult to pick out every single episode in a month where I upload 20 or more videos in order to fit in a month dedicated to a cartoon. Before any of you ask, I don't have any plans on doing a Steven Universe week or month dedicating it. So don't expect me to do a plan like that in 2022, but I might reconsider. Just keep that in mind. I'm giving this episode a 7.25 out of 10, and the next time I'm getting back to Steven Universe, it's not gonna be on the Christmas episode because it's not really a Christmas episode when it's mostly about Paul, Garnet, and Amethyst taking care of baby Steven and nothing else. So, during the final days of this year, it could possibly be on the Carnivore Anthology again. Although at the same time, I'm gonna be having a difficult time getting to that because Christmas is always gonna be a month where it's gonna be more difficult than the last.